The purpose of the Newtonian fluid viscosity measurement experiment is to determine the viscosity of Newtonian fluids using two different methods. The first method of determining viscosity utilizes Seybolt universal viscometers. There are two Seybolt devices. One device will be used to measure the viscosity of 10W30 and 30 weight motor oils at 100 degrees Fahrenheit. The other device will be used to measure the viscosity of the same two motor oils at 210 degrees Fahrenheit. Each device consists of sample wells that contain a test section reservoir, an overflow rim, a calibrated orifice, and a cork stopper. The viscosity of both oils will be determined by measuring the amount of time necessary for 60 milliliters of the fluid to flow through the orifice into a calibrated flask. The oils in this experiment will be heated to temperatures hot enough to cause injury. For safety reasons, the instructor should be the only person touching the Seybolt device and handling the oils. The 100 degree Fahrenheit experiment will be conducted first. Set up this experiment by turning on the thermal bath on the Seybolt device labeled 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Then fill one sample well with 10W30 oil and the other sample well with 30 weight oil. Start the thermal bath by turning on both the line switch and the light switch. Then turn the control knob to high, or H as it appears on the knob. It can take many minutes for the thermal bath to reach the desired temperature, so instructors may want to complete this step about 15 minutes before the start of the experiment. Only the two sample wells at the front of the Seybolt device will be used in this experiment. First, remove the lid to the front left sample well. Place a filter over the well and slowly pour in fresh 10W30 oil. Allow the oil to drain through the filter between small pores and check the oil level in the test section periodically. Once the test section is full and the filter completely drained, remove the filter and set it aside. Using a suction bulb, carefully extract any oil in the overflow rim and deposit it in the waste oil container. Then replace the sample well lid. Using a different filter, repeat this process with 30 weight oil in the front right sample well. Once both oils are approximately 100 degrees Fahrenheit, the viscosity measurement may begin. The viscosity of the 10W30 oil will be determined first, followed by the 30 weight oil. Remove the lid to the 10W30 oil sample well and check the temperature by inserting a digital thermometer and gently stirring the oil. Once the temperature is within a couple degrees of 100 degrees Fahrenheit, the test can begin. So place a calibrated flask beneath the test section. Gently toggle the cork to remove it and start the timer as soon as the oil begins to flow. Stop the timer as soon as the oil passes the 60 milliliter mark on the flask. Leave the flask in place until the sample well has completely drained, and repeat this process for the 30 weight oil using a different 60 milliliter flask. After the sample wells have drained completely, set the two flasks with the used oil aside as they will be used again in the 210 degree Fahrenheit experiment. Then, gently place the cork stoppers back into the bottom of the sample wells. Finally, turn off the thermal bath by rotating the control knob to the off position, and then turn off both the light and line switches. Set up the 210 degree Fahrenheit experiment by turning on the thermal bath on the Sable device labeled 210 degrees Fahrenheit. Then one sample well will be filled with the used 10W30 oil, and the other sample well will be filled with the used 30 weight oil. Start the thermal bath by turning on both the line switch and the light switch. Then turn the control knob to high, or H as it appears on the knob. It can take many minutes for the thermal bath to reach the desired temperature, so instructors may want to complete this step about 15 minutes before the start of the experiment. Remove the lid to the front left sample well and place the 10W30 oil filter above it. Slowly pour the flask of used 10W30 oil into the test section. Take care to allow the oil to drain out of the filter between small pores, and check the oil level in the test section periodically. If the flask does not provide sufficient oil to completely fill the test section, add fresh oil. Once the test section is filled and the filter is completely drained, set the filter aside. Using the suction bulb, carefully extract any oil in the overflow rim and deposit it in the waste oil container. Then replace the sample well lid. Repeat this process with the front right test section for 30 weight oil, making sure to use the 30 weight oil filter. Once both oils reach the desired temperature, the viscosity measurement may begin. The viscosity of the 10W30 oil will again be determined first, followed by the 30 weight oil. Be sure to wear protective gloves, as the heated oil can burn your skin. Remove the lid to the 10W30 oil sample well and check the temperature by inserting a digital thermometer and gently stirring the oil. Once the thermometer reading is within a couple degrees of 210 degrees Fahrenheit, the test can begin, so place a calibrated flask beneath the test section. Gently toggle the cork to remove it and start the timer as soon as the oil begins to flow. Stop the timer as soon as the oil passes the 60 milliliter mark on the flask. Leave the flask in place until the sample well has completely drained, and repeat this process for the 30 weight oil using a different 60 milliliter flask. After the sample wells have drained completely, set the two flasks with the used oil aside, and gently place the cork stoppers back into the bottom of the sample wells. Turn off the thermal bath by rotating the control knob to the off position and turn off both the light and line switches. Then pour the used oil into the mixed oil waste container. The second method of determining viscosity utilizes a Kanin-Fenske routine viscometer. This type of viscometer consists of a continuous glass capillary tube with one end wider than the other. There are two timing marks on the tube that are used to determine the kinematic viscosity of fluids. Kanin-Fenske routine viscometers are available in many different sizes. It is important to select a size that will produce a flow time of at least 200 seconds for both the test fluid, which is kerosene, and the calibration fluid, which is water. A size 50 viscometer should produce sufficiently long flow times for both fluids. After selecting a viscometer, it is necessary to determine the calibration constant that is specific to that particular viscometer. The calibration constant will be determined using water, then the kinematic viscosity of kerosene will be obtained. Finally, the density of kerosene will be determined in order to calculate its dynamic viscosity. Fill a tall beaker with distilled water and place the narrow end of the viscometer into it. Draw water into the viscometer using a clean suction bulb on the viscometer's wide end. Fill the viscometer with water until the fluid level is above both timing marks. Remove the viscometer from the water, then invert it, and place it on a ring stand, making sure that the test section is vertical. Start the timer as soon as the fluid level reaches the first timing mark, and stop it again when the fluid level reaches the second one. When the calibration procedure is complete, pour the water into the sink and dry the interior of the viscometer with a rolled up paper towel. Repeat this procedure with kerosene, but do not pour the kerosene into the sink. The density of kerosene is determined by placing a 60 milliliter flask on a digital scale and pressing the tear button. Then fill the flask with kerosene to the 60 milliliter mark and place it back on the scale to measure its mass. Pour the kerosene from both the viscometer and 60 milliliter flask back into the container of kerosene, not into the sink. Use a non-toxic cleaning solution, such as Simple Green all-purpose solution, to clean the interior of the viscometer and flask. Then dry with a rolled up paper towel.